Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. How are you? Good morning. Bersama Chef dalam platform Chef Zairi, iaitu Kitchen Chef Zairi dan rancangan Chef, untuk penerangan, sesi penerangan dan sesi tunjuk ajar kepada adik-adik di luar sana, pada anda untuk mempelajari bersama Chef berkenaan membuat resipi-resipi tertentu lah. So I want to share with you all people how we make something like this one kind of rice. It's I call beef rice, served with tamarind chutney. It's a Malaysian traditional cuisine. So at least you all outside there can know, learn with me. I will show you step by step, one by one, what ingredient we use, then technique of cooking, from A until finish. Sini saya akan tunjuk kepada anda, saya akan terang kepada anda bahan-bahan yang digunakan untuk kita buat nasi daging cara utara, cara Pulau Pinang sikit. Akan dimakan bersama air asam. Nasi daging air asam lah dipanggil. Nasi daging air asam. So, bahan kita perlukan. First, you know, nasi saya gunakan basmati. I use a basmati rice, about 3 cup. 3 cup basmati rice. Of course, the first, the second one is a... Now the second one, I'll explain you. The second one is beef broth. Boil the beef, separate the beef from the broth. So beef broth. It's a beef slice. Air daging, daging telah direbus hingga empuk. Kita akan pecah, kita asingkan dia. Air dan daging. So these two kind we make. Juice we make for the replace for the water. Kita nak akan guna untuk untuk air. Then of course we need the slice item. Normally we need onion. Kita perlukan bawang, just one number of onion, 3 pieces of garlic, 1/2 inch of ginger and lemongrass. Bawang besar, halia, serai 3 biji, 3 ulas, bawang kecil, and screw pine leaf, daun pandan, untuk menumis. This lemongrass you can get in America. Everything can get, this screw pine leaf, this lemongrass you can get in America. You just mention the name only to the Asian grocery, you can get everything you can get. First spice, the third spice, kurma powder. It's a kurma powder about 30 gram. Sebut kurma dalam 30 gram. Kurma powder dicampur sedikit serbuk lada hitam. This is the black pepper, crushed black pepper. Crushed black pepper, you just put little bit. Then we need milk. This one certain milk. No problem, any kind brand. Here I use Carnation milk. Carnation certain milk. And condensed milk, susu pekat, susu cair, of course a bit salt and sugar, a bit sugar, and finally we garnish with some red chili, green chili, fried shallot, fried shallot, bawang goreng. Kita akan hias dengan bawang goreng selepas siap, hijau merah, cili hijau, cili merah. Inilah bahan-bahan kita perlukan untuk kita membuat nasi daging. Here is ingredient we need to make it beef rice. So I explain to you. Already done. Now what I'm doing, we start with the slice item first. This one you just pull it like, and kita ikatkan dia. Lemongrass, the snow, so like this, sliced onion. You can blend, no problem. Anda boleh blend juga kalau anda tak nak slice pun boleh, terpulang. of ginger, irisan halia, thyme julienne. If you cannot, you don't know how to use knife, be careful, use knife lah. Kalau tak pandai jangan buat macam chef lah, bahaya sikit lah. Bagi yang dah biasa ni tak mengapa lah. Slowly ikat lah. Don't take style like me ya. Jangan ikut cara chef ni, kalau dah biasa tak apa kan. Kita dah memang tukar masak dah, kita dah tahu dah. So this one is called salty ingredient, bahan-bahan untuk kita tumis eh. Begitu. Okay. First, the basmati rice about 3 cup. You need to wash first, then put inside the bowl, something like this bowl. Put water, soak about 30 minutes. 30 minutes, after 30 minutes, you strain it. Drain. So we don't want the water, you want the rice. Anda basuhkan basmati, beras basmati ikut sukatan anda lah. Di sini saya gunakan 3 cup lah. Kita basuh, kemudian kita rendamkan dalam setengah jam. Biar dalam selepas setengah jam, kita akan tapiskan, kesejatkan dia. 3 cup of basmati rice. Just put in, throw in inside the rice cooker. Masuk langsung terus ke dalam rice cooker. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Even inside rice cooker. Okay. The old school style. You use a hand. See? Just. You mean the rice like this. Dekat tu air dia. Dekat tu beras permukaan dari bawah sampai atas. From bottom to top like this. So, water also same. From top the rice until the end, same also. So, this one traditional style. Ini cara-cara orang dulu-dulu lah. Orang dulu-dulu dia pakai begitu kan. Dan kita dah pakai cup yang senang sikit kan. Okay, already done. Now we saute. The item. Open the fire, heat the fire. Put oil a little bit, about 100 ml, 100 ml minyak. Okay, you heat the oil. You put some. You can use a ghee oil or butter. Unsalted butter. Anda boleh gunakan minyak sapi atau mentega lah. Just 2 spoon like that. Preheat the oil and the butter a few minutes. Panaskan seketika minyak dan mentega. If you use ghee oil, more nice, more smell the flavors, smell is nice, more nice. So I forget one more. Yes, these are spices. This you need to put cardamom, bit cardamom. Clove and then this one cinnamon stick and bay leaf. Ha, dah masukkan empat serangkai itu. Ha. Tricky, ha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Everything. Daun salam, bay leaf, cinnamon stick, clove, and cardamom. It's on the spices, and you put spices. It's okay, big, nanti yellow. Nah, dah tumiskan dia sekejap, bagi dia kekuningan. Ini daging yang telah dimasak. So the ratio for the rice, for the beef broth, rice about 3. So you need to put 4 cup. Huh? Throw inside the rice cooker. You see that? 1. And 4 cup. Almost yellow. We put the this one, kurma powder. Masukkan sebut kurma, about 30 gram. Put a bit water. Masukkan sedikit air. Tomat macam kita kita. Yeah, low the fire. Eh? Low heat the fire. Put a bit water. Just a bit. Masukkan sedikit air. Become tomat kan. Right, and beef broth nasi dengan air daging lah, dimasuk dalam rice cooker. Then separate. This one sweetened milk, half cup of it, setengah cawan susu cair Carnation, half cup. Put inside the rice cooker. Throw inside the rice cooker. So, heat. Heat. Ha? Cara dia lah. Cara-cara lama-lama lah. 3 cup of rice. 4 cup of beef broth. 3 cawan beras basmati. 4 cawan air. Rebusan daging. Dan setengah cawan susu cair. Done. Close. Put everything. Stir it. Then remove this one. Then can put some beef inside. Yeah, throw the beef inside. Masukkan sedikit daging yang rebusan daging. Ha? Then we add it with salt. Buat 2 teaspoon nak masukkan dalam 2 sudu kecil garam ah. Kalau anda rasa lebih sikit tambahkan ah. Dua sudu kecil gula. Dua sudu besar makan susu pekat. 2 tablespoon condensed milk. Stir it. Kacaukan dia ha, ketiga. So before you cook, you taste the sauce first. How? So you need one more sauce. 1 sudu kecil garam. And we cook. Just cook like normal rice. Eh? Masak yang seperti masak nasi biasalah. Okay, wait for the next step. For the ready one. Okay. Okay, sekarang kita buat untuk bahagian kedua. Iaitu kita buat air asam. Eh? In English, we call something like chutney. Tamarind chutney. Something like tamarind chutney. Eh? So, bahan-bahan kita perlu di sini. Untuk kita buat air asam untuk nasi daging itu, bawang, onion dalam 2 biji, nah itu 2 biji onion, cili hijau 1/2, cili merah, cili kecil, cili kecil, cili kecil, cili hijau kecil, cili merah, cili padi lah lebih kurang, cili padi. Sebiji tomato, 5 kasturi lime, 5 kasturi, asam jawa, asam jawa dan sedikit belacan lah, sedikit belacan, air, gula dan garam lah, gula dan garam. So ini kita, untuk kita membuat bahan air asam lah. Today saya want to show you. Explain to you how Malaysian we make like traditional tamarind chutney. So what item we have, we need, first we need the onion, Bombay onion, or you can use Holland onion, that's no problem. Green chili, 1 red chili, 1 bird chili, small one bird chili, green color one. 1 number of tomato and something like lime. You can use a lemon also, no problem, because we need the water only. Then water, of course water. Then we need tamarind paste. This one shrimp paste, you know, in America you can get this, so both this you can get in a Asian grocery. You can get, you just mention the name of tamarind paste and shrimp paste. So this look like how look like the shrimp paste and tamarind paste. I know America they don't like this shrimp paste. This one smell something like bad smell. If you don't like, you don't put. Should be okay. Nah, this smell. This one original from Thailand, from Indonesia, from Malaysia. You can get this one in Vietnam also. You can get this tamarind paste. Normally in a Vietnam cuisine, Indonesian cuisine, Malaysian cuisine, and Thai cuisine, lot they use this tamarind paste, something like this, tamarind paste. All these things all these ingredients you can get in America. Of course, water, salt and sugar you need to put inside something like chutney, tamarind chutney. Saya akan explain ke anda. Okay, then kita tunjuk satu persatu. I cut one by one, so easy for you all to know how to remake it. Tamarind chutney, air asam. Okay, first we need a bowl. Yes, kita perlukan. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We just slice, fine slice, iris. Just slice, fine slice. It's like traditional, no? Something like traditional, something for the village. Right. For this one, put inside the bowl. Just smash like this. Now tomato. Tomato, buah tomato. Yang di tengah ni kita tak nak. The inside you want. Is cut first, this one, pick up, remove, keluarkan lah, bahagian tengah tu. Just julian, iriskan lah, iriskan lah, just fine julian. Join together, masukkan sekali dalam bekas bawang tadi. Chili, red chili. Make sure everything vegetable you wash first, anda basuhkan semua sayur-sayuran, wash properly, wash. Green chili, red chili hijau. Tamarind chutney, eat with the rice. Today I make beef rice. I use boiling beef. Take the water, make a rice. So the small chili, bird chili, chili kecil, chili padi kecil, hijau, merah. Fine slice. Yeah. Together the bird chili red. Lime, cut tu. Ini the water ni. Kita nak pakai air dia saja. Okey, kunci dia. Ha, campuran semua bahan yang nampak sana. Now, tamarind paste, ha? Asam jawa. Masukkan asam jawa. Shrimp paste. So about just few drop only, ya. Just make like this. Smash like this. Hancur-hancurkan sedikit. Sedikit, ya. Maybe about 5 gram. Something like that. 5 gram gitu. Masukkan ke dalam bekas. How you make a tamarind paste, eh? We need the juice only, eh? Kita nak ambil air dia, eh? Masukkan air sedikit, put the water a little bit. Just something like this. Use glove, eh? Pakai glove, eh? Kalau di rumah kita tak pakai lah, kita basuh tangan cuci bersih, eh? Kalau orang tua-tua kan, mak-mak kita buat. You can get the paste one without seed. You can buy in a grocery, in Asian grocery. Anda boleh dapatkan yang tak punya biji, ya. Jadi senang, kan? Ini masuk paste saja, tambah air, ya. You put the paste, then add in water. Dan inside. Put inside, strain the tamarind. Tapiskan dia. Si. Line, take the juice ni, ambil air perahan limau tu, ha? Kalau bagi anda nak tambah lagi sikit, masukkan asam jawa sikit lagi, ya. Bagi ada macam kuah sikit lah, ha? You want to make something like watery, put little bit water and tamari juice, then I put water a little bit. And finally, last kali, gula. Just to taste only, ya. And salt, sugar and salt, gula dan garam, ya. No need to put salt too much because salt tamarind is already salty. Just mash a little bit. Some people they put the coconut, dry coconut lah. Setengah orang dia letakkan kerisik, kan. Ikutlah, anda nak tambahkan kerisik pun boleh, ha? Tambahkan kerisik, eh, sedikit. Some kerisik. Taste a little bit. sugar. A bit water. Now, we done with the tamarind chutney. Eh? Kita dah siap dengan air asam. Eh? Pastikan dah rasa, ada masam-masam, ada masin sikit, ada pedas-pedas. Make sure the chutney something that this one tastes like sour, tidbit sour, tidbit salty, not too salty, and spicy. This one. Air asam Jawa. Air asam air asam makan bersama nasi daging This one we call in English translate to something like tamarind chutney. Okay. Hope we enjoy, we share, we meet another recipe. Okay. Now already done, we cook and 30 minit we use a rice cooker. Put the rice there. You see. Ni 30 minit garam 30 minit Just take the pork, something like spaghetti pork. Just kacau sikit This one you need to throw This. Ini daun pandan, 10 pandan you need to take out. And then lemon grass also you take out. Put some fried shallot and some chili if you like some chili green and red chili and you can add in also raisin something like color you make the color so the lemongrass like this ini yang serai ni remove lah tak keluar lah dan habis ni slowly slowly stir from bottom to top daripada bawah sampai atas digembukkan gembur sikit boleh tak patah cinnamon stick hasilnya sekarang kalau kita menyaga kalau anda menyaga restoran sendiri If you just scoop the rice, only the rice, because beef is separate, and nasi saja. Ini untuk yang nyaga lah, untuk packaging. Ambil nasi saja for the packaging. Pack one, same also. Just take the rice. Ambil nasi saja. Put in the bowl. This one around 200 gram. Dalam lebih kurang 200 gram. Satu bowl. Siap nasi daging, we already done beef rice special from Kitchen Chef Zairi. So you can learn something from me. You own your restaurant, you can make it new recipe. You just follow step by step. Anda boleh buka sendiri, tanyakan sendiri dan makan bersama keluarga. Bagi anda yang baru kahwin, belajar, belajar tak lagi belajar suatu. So, you see here, 3 step, 2 step. This one like packaging. Ni macam kita bungkus, kita menyaga nasi, kita masukkan nasi di tengah, masukkan daging, air asam, dibungkus lah. Dibungkus asin. Ni chef punya logo lah. jadi packaging lah, something lah, pack food lah. Pack food nasi daging ini chef punya, untuk orang order, untuk yang delivery chef buat lah. Ha? Kalau orang minta, ada permintaan, chef akan buat. Ibu kosong this one lah. Rice, beef rice, beef cook beef and tamarind chutney ya, air asam, daging yang telah direbus dengan daging, masih daging. Masukkan sedikit asam di atas. Ini cantik. Kalau anda ada daun pudina, letakkan sedikit daun pudina di atas. Sini asam lah, ha? Sini asam sedikit lah. Ha? Put the something lah. Mint leaf, something like flower. Can become more nice, more look nice, more elegant. Ha? Okay. This from chef. Nasi daging Pulau Pinang, nasi daging utara lah. Share from me, this is my country food, something like Malaysian typical food, traditional food. Okay, hope your people learn with me something. We will meet again, another recipe. I will make another traditional Malay cuisine kuih. It's something dessert. We put inside my YouTube, okay, so, yeah. Anda boleh tengok juga lagi-lagi kuih Melayu. Chef akan buat tu Melayu dan chef akan buat praktikal juga lah tentang teori, tentang penerangan tentang kulineri ya. Bagi adik-adik di luar sana belajar sesuatu, mungkin sekarang ni kita banyak hotel, sektor hotel tutup kan. So kita ambil ilmu tu, ilmu tu guna. Kalau nak niaga sendiri atau buat di rumah, bagi yang baru-baru berkahwin ni kan, belajar. Kalau masakkan kita sedar, bismillah selawat 3 kali, alhamdulillah insyaAllah. Suami pun sayang. Ha? So, harap kita akan berjumpa lagi dalam my next episode. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. From Chef Zahri. Don't forget share my YouTube Kitchen Chef Zahri. Jangan lupa lihat YouTube Chef. Ha? Anda boleh belajar sesuatu tentang. Adios amigos. Comesta.